Bronchiectasis is a chronic lung condition characterized by irreversible changes to the airway. The term is derived from the Greek translation of bronchi, airway, and ectasis, which means widening. The primary pathologic feature on gross inspection is dilation of the airway. This can be described as cylindrical, which is uniform dilation, varicose, which is an irregular dilation, or actually saccular or balloon-like dilation of the airway. On microscopic evaluation, there's evidence of epithelial ulceration, squamous metaplasia, and infiltration of lymphocytes and neutrophils into the mucosa and submucosa. The lining of the trachea and the major bronchi consist of ciliated columnar epithelium, which gradually become more cuboidal with fewer ciliated cells at the periphery of the airway. The cilia work like an escalator to sweep microbes and debris out of the lungs. In bronchiectasis, the normal propulsion of the cilia is lost, and secretions pool in the dilated airways. As a result of chronic inflammation, the bronchial arteries increase in size and form anastomoses with the pulmonary arterial circulation. With mechanical trauma to the lung, these enlarged vessels may rupture, leading to hemoptysis. Additionally, as the airways lose their normal integrity, they become collapsible, therefore making cough less effective at clearing secretions. There are multiple different causes of bronchiectasis, including genetic, autoimmune, allergic, immune deficiency, and post-infectious. Bronchiectasis may be localized to one area of the lung or found diffusely, and the pattern of that bronchiectasis can afford clues to the underlying etiology. As the airway incurs damage and loses its ability to clear secretions, opportunistic microbes colonize the airways. The colonization of the airway occurs because of the impaired mucociliary clearance and the failure of the neutrophils to phagocytize and kill. The prominent clinical features of bronchiectasis include cough and sputum production. Dyspnea and hemoptysis may be seen in up to 50% of individuals, as well as pleuritic chest pain in a minority. Patients will benefit from airway clearance techniques and adjunctive therapies common for bronchiectasis. Airway clearance strategies should be customized to the patient, considering their preference and motivation. Regardless of the technique chosen, patient education is essential for optimizing the potential for successful therapy.